Hello friends, happy to meet you through this lecture. This lecture is on steam turbine problem part 2. And here we are going to solve few problems on reaction turbine. So in the part 1, we solved the problems on the single stage impulse turbine. And here in this lecture, we solve problems on single stage reaction turbine. Before we take up the problem, we just review what is a reaction turbine and what are the equations to use to calculate the parameters. So reaction turbine consists of a set of fixed blades and moving blades. The steam enters at boiler pressure. From the boiler, the steam enters the turbine, flows through the fixed blade first and then moving blade. You look at the fixed blade and moving blade, both the blades are of similar shape. The shape is called as aerofoil shape and the arrangements are different. So in the fixed blade, as we discussed earlier, it is fixed on the casing of the machine, and the moving blade is fixed on the rotor, which is rotating about the rotor axis, and the power is produced. So look at the flow passage. So the flow passage for the steam between the blades, it is like a converging diverging nozzle. So here also, if you look at here, it is again a converging diverging nozzle. So the arrangement, the orientation of the blade is like that. And when the steam flows through the fixed blade, there is pressure drop. So here all the pressure drop is not taking place in the fixed blade. So for example, you take 50% pressure drop in the fixed blade. Corresponding to this pressure drop, there is increase in velocity. And with the higher velocity and pressure, the steam enters the moving blade. Here the steam is expanded. The velocity is used. Also, there is work produced because of the drop in the pressure. So the work produced in the moving blade is due to the decrease in velocity and decrease in the pressure. So the contribution by the change in kinetic energy and change in the pressure energy. And look at the velocity triangle. So the steam enters the moving blade with the velocity, steam velocity V1. Angle is alpha is the nozzle angle or fixed blade angle. And we have the blade velocity VB, and the vectorial sum of VB and V1 is VR1, relative velocity R1. And with the theta is the angle of the moving blade, the inlet. And this absolute velocity has got two components, vertical component Vf1 and horizontal component Vw1. The steam flows through the relative velocity here and leaves with the relative velocity. So Vr2 is the relative velocity at the outlet and with the angle phi. So phi is the outlet angle of the moving blade. And we have the blade velocity Vb. So V2 is the absolute velocity and Vf2 is the flow velocity at the outlet and Vw is the tangential velocity at the outlet of the moving blade. So the velocity triangle is very much similar to the impulse turbine, but the conditions are different. So we will see what are the conditions, how it is differ from the impulse turbine. So the power produced by the turbine, it is very much similar to the previous equation, P equal to M, mass of the steam into Vw1 plus Vw2 into blade velocity. And axial thrust on the blade, Fx equal to M into Vf1 minus Vf2 in Newton. And here we have to remember the mass flow rate of the steam. So M equal to pi dH into Vf2 divided by Vs. So d is the diameter, mean diameter of the drum, rotor drum. And H is the height of the blade. Vf2 is the flow velocity at the outlet of the rotor. And Vs is the specific volume of the steam for the given pressure and temperature conditions. And here in the reaction turbine, one important parameter is degree of reaction. So degree of reaction, so we said here, if you look at the diagram, there is enthalpy pressure drop in the moving blade as well as the fixed blade. So pressure drop in the fixed blade and the moving blade. So here we define the reaction turbine, degree of reaction equal to enthalpy drop in the moving blade divided by enthalpy drop in the stage. Enthalpy drop in the moving blade is Vr2 square minus Vr1 square by 2, and the enthalpy drop in the stage, it is equal to work done by the reaction turbine, VB into VW1 plus VW2. And substituting the value, we will get the different equation that we will skip here. We just understand what is degree of reaction. And this degree of reaction, it varies from 0 to 100. So, if it is 0, what do you mean by that? Enthalpy drop in the moving blade equal to 0. There is no pressure drop in the moving blade, that becomes the impulse turbine. When it is 1, enthalpy drop in the stage is equal to enthalpy drop in the moving blade, and it is pure reaction turbine, such a turbine is practically not possible. So, the reaction is varying greater than 0 and less than 100. And normally, the steam turbines are designed for 50% reaction turbine. So, the 50% reaction turbine, what do you mean by that? So, the enthalpy drop is shared, 50% enthalpy drop in the moving blade and 50% enthalpy drop in the fixed blade. So, total there will be 100% pressure drop or enthalpy drop in the stage. So, for 50% reaction turbine, we will implement the condition and we will find that VF1 equal to VF2, V1 equal to VR2 and V2 equal to VR1, phi equal to alpha, theta equal to beta. The 50% reaction turbine was first designed by Parson. So, Parson reaction turbine is very popular. And if you implement all these conditions, so we will find that the velocity triangles are symmetrical. So, velocity triangles are symmetrical for the reaction turbine. So, now we take up the problem. First problem, at a particular stage of a reaction turbine, the mean blade speed is 60 meters per second. The steam pressure is 3.5 bar with a temperature of 175 degrees Celsius. The identical fixed moving blades have the inlet angle of theta and outlet angle of 20. Determine the blade height if it is 1 by 10th of the blade ring diameter for a flow rate of 13.5 kilograms per second. And the power developed by the pack. And third, the specific enthalpy drop if the stage efficiency is 85%. So, write down the given data. VB equal to 60 meters per second. Steam pressure and temperatures are 3.5 bar and 175 degrees Celsius. Inlet angle of the blade 30 degree. Outlet angle of the blade 20 degree. H, height of the blade equal to 0.1 times of the diameter. And the mass flow rate is 13.5 kilograms per second. And the stage efficiency is 0.85, 85%. So, we take up the inlet and the exit velocity triangle. They are identical. And we said for reaction turbine, beta equal to theta. What is beta? So, beta is the absolute angle at the outlet, which is theta, which is inlet angle of the blade. And alpha equal to phi. Nozzle angle is equal to outlet angle of the blade, which is 20 degree. And VF1 equal to VF2, V1 equal to VR2, and VR1 equal to V2. And from the inlet velocity triangle, we write this equation. VW1 tan alpha equal to VW1 minus VP tan theta. That is, simplifying and rearranging, we will get VW1 equal to VP tan theta by tan theta minus tan alpha. So, substituting all these values, 60 into 10, 30 divided by 10, 30 minus 10, 20 equal to 162.3 meters per second. So, whirl velocity at the outlet is 162.3 meters per second. And VF1 equal to VW1 tan alpha, which is 162.3 into tan 20 equal to 59 meters per second. And VW2 equal to VW1 minus VP, which is 102.3 meters per second. Now, from the steam table, at a pressure of 3.5 bar and temperature 170 degrees Celsius, the specific volume of the superheated steam is 0.57645 metric cube per kilogram. Now, you write the mass flow rate. From the mass flow rate equation, M equal to pi dHVF divided by V. So, pi d into h equal to 0.1 time of d, which is into Vf divided by V. Substituting for simplifying, we will get 13.5 d square is the unknown. So, solving the mathematical equation, diameter of the blade, diameter of the rotor diameter is 0.65 meter and the height of the blade 0.065 meter, which is 6.5 centimeter. So, because the height of the blade is equal to diameter of the blade divided by 10, 1/10 of the diameter. And the power produced by the turbine, M into VB into VW1 plus VW2. So 13.5 kilograms per second, VB equal to 60 meters per second, and VW1 is 162.3, and VW2 equal to 102.3. So it will be 214.3 kilowatts. And the enthalpy drop in the turbine, so delta H equal to VB into VW1 plus VW2 will be the stage efficiency. Actually, the stage efficiency is VB into VW1 plus VW2 divided by delta H. So, rearranging will get the HC, delta H equal to 18.6 kilojoules per kilogram. And the answer for the problem, height of the blade is 6.5 centimeter, power developed is 214.3 kilowatts, and specific enthalpy drop is 18.6 kilojoules per kilogram. So, as usual, you write down the given data, draw the velocity triangle, calculate the parameter, and then you write down the answer at the end. So this is how you have to approach a problem or answer to a problem in the examination. Then problem number two, the following data, example two, the following data relate to a stage of a reaction turbine. Mean rotor diameter is 1.5 meter, speed ratio 0.72, blade outlet angle 20 degree, rotor speed is 3000 rpm. 1. Determine the diagram efficiency. 2. Determine the percentage increase in diagram efficiency and rotor speed if the rotor is designed to run at the best theoretical speed. You take the exit angle being 20 degree. Then given data, so diameter of the blade, diameter of the rotor is 1.5 meter, VB by V1, speed ratio is 0.72, outlet angle is 20 degree, and speed of the rotor is 3000 rpm. And you take up the draw the velocity triangle, and for reaction turbine the same conditions are applied. So you write down the conditions for the reaction turbine. Now we calculate the blade speed. Blade speed is pi dn by 60. So this is comes as 235.6 meters per second. And steam speed VR2 equal to VR1. Actually, it is VB by 0.72, 235.6 divided by 0.72 equal to 327.2 meters per second. Now, from the inlet velocity triangle, we calculate VW1 as V1 cos alpha, which is 327.2 cos 20, 307.4 meters per second, and VF1 equal to VF2, which is V1 sin alpha, which is 327.2 multiplied by sin 20 is 111.9 meters per second. And the VR1 relative velocity at the inlet, which is square root of VF1 square plus VW1 minus VB square, which is 132.9 meters per second. And VW2 equal to VW1 minus VB, which is 307.41 minus 235.6 equal to 71.8 meters per second. So these are all the velocity vectors from the inlet and the outlet velocity triangle. Now we calculate the diagram efficiency. So the diagram efficiency eta b equal to 2 into 235.6 divided by into 307.4 plus 71.8 multiplied by 100 divided by 327.2 square plus 327.2 square, because V1 equal to VR2 and the VR1 equal to 132.9 square, which is 90.9%. Now For best theoretical speed, sigma equal to VB by V1. The blade speed ratio is VB by V1 equal to cos alpha, which is cos 20 equal to 0.94. So for this best blade speed VB equal to 0.94 times of V1, which is 0.94 into 327.2, which is 307.5 meters per second. Now the rotor speed, from the calculation, n equal to VB into 60 divided by pi into d. This is 307.5 into 60 divided by 5 into 1.5, which is 3917 revolutions per minute. Now, the percentage increase in diagram efficiency. So, for the given blade speed ratio, the efficiency is 90.9. For the best speed ratio 0.94, the efficiency is 93.8. So the change in percentage increase in efficiency 93.8 minus 90.9 divided by 93.8 equal to 3.09%. and percentage increase in rotor speed. Original rotor speed is 3000 rpm and the increase in rotor speed is 3917 rpm. So 3917 minus 3000 divided by 3917 equal to 23.4%. The answer is diagram efficiency is 90% originally. The percentage increase in diagram efficiency is 3.09%. Percentage increase in the speed, rotor speed is 23.4%. And we will take the example 3. A 50% reaction turbine running at 400 rpm has the exit angle of the blade 20 degree and the velocity of the steam related to the blade at the exit is 1.35 times of the mean speed of the blade. The steam flow rate is 8.33 kilograms per second and at a particular stage the specific volume is 1.381 meter cube per kilogram. Calculate for this stage 1. Suitable blade height assuming rotor mean diameter is 12 times the blade height and diagram work. The stage 1. And the given data n equal to 400 rpm, phi equal to alpha equal to 20 degree, VR2 equal to 1.35 times of VB. That is what given here. The velocity of steam related to the blade at the exit VR2, which is 1.35 times of the mean blade speed. So mass flow rate is 8.33 kilograms per second and diameter is 12 times of the height. And for reaction turbine, we have the conditions beta equal to theta, alpha equal to phi equal to 20 degree, VF1 equal to VF2, V1 equal to VR2 and VR1 equal to V2. Now from the exit velocity triangle, so this is what our exit velocity triangle. So the VR2, this length equal to VF2 divided by sin phi, which is 2.92 into V of 2, and cos phi, you write the cos phi equation, which is VB plus VW2 divided by VR2, which is VB by VR2 plus VW2 by VR2, and this ratio is given, VR2 by VB is given as 1.5, so this cos 20 equal to 1 by 1.35 plus VW2 divided by VR2 from the previous equation, 2.92 times of VF2, so simplifying, we'll get VFW2 by VF2 equal to 0.583. Now, we take beta, calculate beta, which is, I take tan beta, tan inverse of beta equal to VF2 by VW2, which is tan inverse of the reciprocal of the value, 1 by 0.583, which is 59.7 degree. So, this beta now, it is 59.7 degree. So, this beta equal to theta, beta equal to theta. Now, you refer to the inlet velocity triangle. VF1 equal to V1 sin alpha, V1 into sin theta equal to 0.342 V1. We take this as equation number 1 and we write VW1 tan alpha equal to VW1 minus VB into VB, VW minus VB into tan theta. So, rearranging VB equal to VW1 into tan theta minus tan alpha divided by tan theta. So, this VW1 equal to V1 cos alpha into tan theta minus tan alpha by tan theta, substituting all the values, we'll get VB equal to 0.74 times of V1. Now we take the blade speed VB, which is pi dn by 60, you substitute for the diameter 12 times of H. So 12 times of H, that is 400 divided by 60, that gives 251.3. times of H, or H equal to 0.004 times of V. So, these are all the calculations and we will refer to the next equation. To take the mass flow rate, mass flow rate M equal to pi d H Vf by small v specific volume. So, phi diameter equal to 12 times of H and H is there and Vf divided by V1, V small v specific volume. So, pi into 12 H square into Vf divided by specific volume. Now, mass flow rate equal to pi into 12 into H equal to, in terms of Vb, 0.004 times of Vb square into Vb square. And substituting all the value, M equal to 8.33, 12.004, Vb square, Vb divided by 1.381. So, we'll get Vb square into Vf equal to 19071.6. Now, we substitute VB and VF, substituting VB and VF from the equation 1 and 2. So, what is one equation 1? Equation 1, VF in terms of V1 and equation 2 Vb in terms of V1. We substitute here and we'll simplify, we'll calculate V1 equal to 46.7 meters per second. Absolute velocity at the inlet, 46.7 meters per second. So immediately we can calculate Vb equal to 0.74 times of V1, which is 0.74 into 46.7 equal to 34.5 meters per second. And Vw1 equal to V1 cos alpha, which is 46.7 into cos 20 equal to 43.9 meters per second. And Vf1 equal to Vf2 equal to V1 sin alpha, which is 46.7 into sin 20 equal to 15.9 meters per second. And Vw2 equal to Vf2 by tan beta, which is 15.9 divided by tan 59.7, which is 9.3 meters per second. So we calculate all the velocity vector once we know the value of V1. Then diameter of the rotor, D equal to Vb into 60 divided by pi into n. So 34.5 into 60 divided by 5 into 400 equal to 1.65 meters. This is the diameter of the rotor. And height of the rotor blade, H equal to D divided by 12, which is 1.65 divided by 12 equal to 0.1375 meter, which is 13.75 centimeter. And diagram work equal to M into Vb into Vw1 plus Vw2, which is 8.33 into 34.5 multiplied by 43.9 plus 9.3 equal to 15.3 kilowatts. So the answers are height of the rotor blade is 13.75 centimeter and diagram work equal to 15.3 kilowatts. We take the example 4. In a Parsan turbine running at 1500 rpm, available enthalpy drop of for an expansion is 65 kilojoules per kilogram. If the mean diameter of the rotor is 100 centimeter, find the number of rows of moving blades required, assuming stage efficiency is 80%, blade outlet angle is 20 degree and speed ratio is 0.7. So write down the given data, rotor speed is 1500 rpm, enthalpy drop of the turbine is 65 kilojoules per kilogram, diameter is 1 meter, stage efficiency is 0.8, outlet angle phi equal to alpha equal to 20 degree, speed ratio Vb by V1 equal to 0.7. So blade speed we calculate Vb equal to pi dn by 60, which is pi into 1 into 1500 by 60 equal to 78.5 meters per second. And from the blade speed ratio we calculate V1 equal to Vb by 0.7, 78.5 divided by 0.7 equal to 112.5 meters per second. Now we take the velocity triangle. From the velocity triangle, Vw1 equal to V1 cos alpha, which is 112.1 into cos 20 equal to 105.3 meters per second. And Vw2 equal to Vw1 minus Vb, which is 105.3 minus 78.5 equal to 26.8 meters per second. So the stage enthalpy drop equal to Vb work done, Vb into Vw1 plus Vw2 stage efficiency, which is 78.5 multiplied by 105.3 plus 26.8 divided by 0.8 equal to 12.96 kilowatts. And the number of stages equal to total enthalpy drop in the turbine divided by enthalpy drop in your stage. That is equal to 65 divided by 12.96 equal to 5 stages. So we require 5 stages of the reaction turbine to have this efficiency and the enthalpy drop. So the number of stages, the answer number of stages required is 5. So thank you. We'll meet again.